Welcome back for a second example on how to find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix using the cofactor method. Using the cofactor method, to calculate the determinant of a 3x3 matrix, we multiply each element in any row or column of a matrix by its cofactor. The sum of these products is equal to the determinant, where the cofactor of each element is equal to -1 raised to the power of I plus j, where I is the row and j is the column of the given element, and m, the minor, is equal to the 2x2 determinant formed by eliminating the row and column of the given element. So going back to our example, the first step is to decide which row or column we want to use to calculate our determinant. And since we have a 0 in row 3, column 1, it'll be easiest if we use either row 3 or column 1. Let's go ahead and use row 3 to calculate our determinant. So we'll have the determinant of matrix A. It's going to be equal to the first element in our row, which is 0, times -1 raised to the power of the sum of the row and column of this element. This element is in row 3, column 1, and 3 plus 1 is 4, so we're going to raise this to the fourth power. Now, of course, we could stop here because we're multiplying by 0, but let's go ahead and continue just to review. So now we're going to multiply this by the 2x2 determinant formed by eliminating the row and column of this element. So we'll eliminate row 3 and column 1, leaving us with these four elements to form our 2x2 determinant. So we'll have -3, 4, 6, 8. Now we'll move to the next element in this row, which is -2. So we'll have plus -2 times -1 raised to the power of, well, this element is in row 3, column 2, 3 plus 2 is 5, so now we'll raise -1 to the fifth power. And we'll multiply this by a 2x2 determinant formed by eliminating the row and column of this element here. So we'll eliminate row 3, column 2 this time, leaving us with the elements 2, 4, -1, 8. Plus the last element in our row, which is +1, times -1 raised to the power of the row plus the column of the element that we're using. This is in row 3, column 3. 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. We'll multiply this by the 2x2 determinant formed by eliminating the row and column of our element. So we'll eliminate row 3 and column 3. So the elements that we'll use will be 2, -3, -1, 6. And now we're left to simplify this. The first product will be 0. That's why we decided to use row 3. Now looking at the next product, we have -1 to the fifth, that's -1, times -2. So we have plus +2 times the value of our 2x2 determinant, which would be 2 times 8 minus 4 times -1. Well, 2 times 8 is 16, 4 times -1 is -4, 16 minus -4 is +20, plus, here we have -1 to the 6th, that's +1 times 1, so we have 1 times the value of our determinant, which again would be 2 times 6 minus -3 times -1. So we would have 12 minus 3, or +9. So we have 0 plus 40 plus 9, which is equal to 49. So the determinant of matrix A is equal to +49. Remember, we can also indicate a determinant using vertical bars. So we could also indicate this determinant using this notation here. If you want to see the same determinant using the diagonal method, I'll put a link on the screen. I hope you found this helpful.